So this is a part 5 of banking project. So it's a VB.NET project. In today's video, let us understand how to make account form, how to generate a new account number, and also let us understand SQL group functions. So these are the three important things here. One is to create the new form. So we already know like how to create the form, but here we have to use one more control drop-down list box, and then how to populate the drop-down list box with the account type. And let us discuss about the SQL group functions and generate the new account number using the group function. So SQL group functions are concerned. So we should know SQL, that is a structured query language. So it's a common language for all the RDBMS. In that, group functions are a part actually. So there are 5 group functions here: average, count, max, minimum, maximum. So average is used to calculate the average values, average value. Count is to get the number of rows, or it will return the number of rows. Max, calculate the maximum. Minimum, calculate the minimum. Sum, calculating the sum. So what does that mean? Let us understand it step by step. So if you consider a table, so this is the salary table. This is employee ID, employee name, salary. There are 5 employees, and these are the names, and this is the corresponding values. Now how do you use this? So you can use this functions with a select statement. You can write select. So here is the average, okay? So we can say average AVG of which column? So we can take the salary column, average of salary from salary table. So let's assume that this is the salary table. So salary table. Now what happened? So you'll add all the values and then take the average. So if you add and divide by 5, then you'll get the average. So how much it is? It is 12, 18, 20. So 20 divided by 5. So you'll get 4000 as a average salary. So this function will return this value. This is what the average function will do. The next is a count. Count is used to count the number of rows. Like now, for example, in the table. So here you can see there are only 5 records, but in some tables there are more records that we want to know at any given time how many records are there. In that case, what you have to do is you say count. So generally you use the star from salary table. So this will return total rows. So you have to select count star from the salary table. Therefore, this will return 5 because there are only 5 records are there here. Then max, who getting the max salary, which is the maximum salary. So therefore, you have to write select max of salary from sal table. That is the table name. Now, what is the maximum salary? 7000 is the maximum salary. Therefore, you'll get 7000 as a maximum salary. Same you can say minimum salary. So you can say minimum salary. Then what is the minimum salary? That 1000 is the minimum salary. So sum of salary. You want to find all the salary. So what is the total sum? So 20. So therefore it is a 20,000. So 20,000 is the total salary. That's how we can use these functions and then we can calculate. We have a separate videos for this, so how to work with our group functions, please watch them also, therefore you'll get a more idea. So if you want to download this project, please visit here iblix.com, download, and also please subscribe to our channel, and also please suggest our channel to your friends, our relatives who are doing computer science course, definitely is very useful for them, and also who are seeking job. So here in our channel, we provide all these free projects, so therefore they can download, they can work, they can add up these titles in their resume, so therefore we'll give a more mileage. Therefore please suggest to all job seekers our channel, and if you like the video, click like button, and you want to say something to us, please write it in the comment box. So here we have in Visual Studio now. So previously we done all these things from the last four classes, and in today's class we have to create the account form. So therefore you can just open the new form, account form. Right, so you'll have a empty form here, again go to the background color. So choose the back color, which color you want. And then go to Punt, select Vardhana, then 12, and done. Right. We can do it much more easier, like instead of creating the form, doing all these things and all. So we can copy and paste the existing forms. I'll just show you like later, like how to do that. Fine. So now this is the account form. Again, here also we require a control. So what we do is we can go to account form. We copy all these controls, Control C, and then you can come back here and then paste. So you can see that we got all the controls. Right. Now you can see account tab, account number. So therefore this is the account number. So just copy and then paste. Okay. So therefore you can have account type here. So now this is the account number. So change this name to account number. So next you require account name or account type. So account type actually. What type of account it is. For this we require a new control. So that is a comma box. So you can use the comma box here. Okay, otherwise you can reduce the size here. Then next is the person name, account holder name. So just say name or customer name. So this is the text box too. So after that you require a address. So copy this first. Sorry. So here we have address. So next required one more for mobile number. So we required one more for email ID. So take this as address. Next one is mobile number. So next one is email. So we copy the control again, text box, paste. Then you want to make it multi-line, okay? So therefore if you click on this tick mark, make it multi-line. So you can enter multi-line data here. So then copy this, paste. So we can enter mobile number over here. Right, so you record one more. So paste it again. So you'll get a one more text box and keep it here. Now adjust all the thing. So now this is for email ID, text box 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then this is the combo box. So now in a combo box, what are the account type already there that we want to transfer here? So in order to transfer this, what you have to write? So you need to write the code here. So we go to account type form. So we import the SQL client, because SQL client, wherever data connectivity is there, wherever you need to access the database, you need to use the SQL client. Then these two strings are required. So copy them and then place them here. So you can double click on new. So then all the buttons, so you can see click events are generated. Now next what you can do is, what are this new, we can copy this, we can come back here. So when I click new, so we can paste this and save whatever we written already. That is also we can copy as it is, because you can reuse the same code. Okay, you don't need to write it again and again. So paste this here. And for close, new me.close. Done. Next, now what is the next step? So we need to call this data, what are the records are there, to this combo box. So in order to do this, go to load event. This is the account form load event. So load event, load first, okay? So therefore, I can copy this now. So this is a select statement. So let me paste the select statement. Now here, I can select the column. Account type name from account type tab, then you don't require where condition, but you require order by. So therefore you can write order by here, order by account type name. Okay, so we can delete everything, otherwise you can write like this: select account type name from account type tab, order by account type name. So we want to select all the account type, only account type, not details. So then you should be ordered by account type name. Then connection open, then you have SQL command, then you have SQL data reader. Now here if condition, but we need to read all the records, therefore you need to use the while read. So while read, then there is an end while. So and this is not required, we can delete it off. While and end while. So while there is a record, okay, dr1.read, read means there is a record, okay. If there is a record, it will come over here. Now what we can do is we can write kumbhabox1 dot items dot add. We can add the item to this. So what item? So dr1 of 0. So dr1 of 0 means that is a one first column, so it is only one column, so therefore that column data only will go to this one. So okay, now this is done. So next, as we discussed already, we need to generate the number, okay. So therefore we need to generate the number, so therefore this is not required here. So we can go back to this. When I click new, so here select one, okay, that let me check. So this is, we clear everything. Then we need to select the account number, new account number. So therefore you have to write max account number from account tab. So this is the table name you have to change, account tab. Then there is no account, okay. So therefore you have to say select max account number from account tab from this table. Then if read, what you have to do? So you need to send that value to the text box one dot text is equal to dr1 of 0, right? So if there is a record, we can send here, and also you can clear all the text boxes. Therefore you can write 3, 4, 5. So this is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. And 1 is not required because any number will come, even you don't clear also, it's okay, that's fine. But okay, so we'll see that. Okay, so what will happen, we'll see this one. So text box 2 dot select. Now 3 things we have done. So one is to select the account type and transfer to the kumbhabox. Second one, so select the next number. Now here is the insert, so therefore you can write account tab values, so account number text box 1. So again you don't require a single quotes on both the sides, we need to remove them. So next, so here kumbhabox 1 has to come, so therefore you can write kumbhabox 1 dot text because this is the account type. So next, account type in the text box 2. Next one is 3, this is 3, 4, 5. So now this is 3, this is 4, and this is 5. Right. So this is the 5. Now we can able to insert the record. So this is the code you need to write in the account form. So then you have to go to MDA parent, and then you need to link that one. So here is the account detail, almost same. So therefore account form dot window state is equal to 2, then account form dot MDI parent is equal to me, account form dot show. So this is the code required to open this form. So now save all, run this, account details, so you can see that new. So now you can see that there is an error, conversion from the type db null, string not valid. So now it return the null value. So here is the null value. Why null value? Because this is totally empty, there are no records here, there are no records. So because of that it's showing error. How to solve this? So you need to check with IIF. IIF is a if condition. Is db null? If this is null, so what are the values null, then you put 1001 here. Otherwise, dr1 of 0. So what is the meaning of is? So is DB null? So we'll check whether it's a null or not. If it is a null, you put 1001 here. Else, what are the value you have to take? And also, to take the next number, you have to give plus 1. Max plus 1 you have to take. Therefore, you can get the next number. Right. Now, we'll see how it works. Account details. Click new. You can see 1001. So now we'll have a zero balance account. Name. Let's say Ravi. Address. So complete the address. Then you have mobile number here. Then email ID. So click save. Fine. So everything is goes well. Record saved. Now if I click new, you can see that 1002 comes. So because of this code, max account number, we'll select the 1001 plus 1 become 1002. So that will be transferred over there. So therefore it becomes 1002. Now you can write another name, Chandan. Then you can have some address here. Mobile number. Fine. So save, record saved. So like that, we can save the records. Now if you go to account tab and show table data, so you can see that what are the data you entered, it is there here. So these indicate like how you can generate the new number. And also how to call the data, what are the data is here, how to call the data to the Kumbh box one. So this is the Kumbh box one. So in the code, you need to write this code to select the data and transfer to the Kumbh box one. And this one to generate the new number, this one to save the record. So hope you understand the concept. So please try all these things, then you'll definitely get the answers. There may be some errors, so don't worry. So check it out why the error is coming and what is the reason behind it. So once you solve this, you get a lot of experience. The next time when that kind of error comes, you definitely can able to solve that problem. Okay, keep try, keep do, get the experience. Thank you.